What's up guys, Gun Scorch here, and if you guys are getting a brand new GTA 5 video. So today we have the Benefactor Glendale Custom. And somebody commented on... That's not how to get to that page. Somebody commented when I did my Penumbra FF video that, apparently I don't know how to drift because I don't stance the vehicles. Well, my opinion on that is if you have to stance a vehicle in order to be able to drift it, then you don't know how to drift. If you can drift an unstanced vehicle, then you're pretty much guaranteed to be able to drift a stanced vehicle. I mean, obviously you might have to change up your style, but... He also said that it was more of power drifting. First off, it's called power sliding. And... Yeah, because you can't drift an all-wheel drive vehicle. You can't. It's called power sliding. So anywho, that's my rant for today. Too bad, minus the hole. I got that one a little too soon. I get it. Like he didn't even look. He was just like, oh, light turned green. Okay, let's go. He's not even watching for idiots driving on the road. All stancing is you shoot your rim or like the fender or skirt around the rim or like around your tires, and it damages the suspension and lowers the body of your car. And by damaging the suspension, the handling file reads it as the tires are getting damaged, so they lose traction. So therefore, it helps people drift. But obviously not everyone knows how to do that. I didn't. I just learned yesterday. But, So yeah, this is more of a test of, okay, people are just being new to GTA and they want to figure out how to drift. And they don't know any car glitches and whatnot, so I'm doing pretty bad around that. Pretty consistent. Really easy to control. Although this is gonna be a bad one, but it's actually doing halfway decent. I say that and it basically stalls. Can do a single one over here. Not very well. I don't think it's going fast enough. Bigger it is, well, still kind of doesn't, but they're alright. Got a little butter going down, but points are points, I guess. Honestly, I'll probably go with Logitech. that go. I get some mad points for that one. That one right at the beginning. Like, woo, that was a good one. Did it when I was going up that one. And by that one, I mean that time. Not too bad about that one, too. I think the vehicle could use to be a little faster, but. Almost good. It was going pretty good too. I thought those cars at least turned. Yep. Honestly, it doesn't do bad. It could use to be a little faster. Probably a little less expensive too, but no, it is what it is. Yeah, it was about $1 million. Which means, really, I should only get $500,000 back. Honestly, it didn't do too bad. It used to be a little faster than I think it would take the bigger figure eights and do those a little better. Just go through the man's leg, and he didn't care.
Today.
Well, LSU was glitching up there for a sec. $2,000 to repair. Let's see. Around 650,000, so about 1.3 mil. Whatever the sell price is, double that, and that's how much money you put into the car. Excluding repairs. I will probably get it a 7 out of 10. I forget which one I gave an 8 out of 10, but I feel like it's not quite up to snuff for that. Yeah, 7 out of 10. Not too bad, Mr. Glendale. Not too bad. That being said, I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out.